So the fusion of high-energy density batteries, autonomous systems, put into aircraft was a vision they had a while back, and it was about getting astronauts, mobility, and EVA into one synergistic, harmonistic system, such that you could...
That's your controller, you can see it on there. This swaps tools.
So, can you get into the workstation, the medical workstation?
Yes.
Which one of these is
the... Do you know if these... it's the leading edge move.
Mapped exact same.
Okay. Did you say... You said outlined in gray. There's yellow outlines. So
I'm sorry. Outlined in yellow. Anything that's outlined in yellow aircraft, by the way. And so, really only for takeoff and landing. The high lift propeller blades are powered, and then when you're up to the right speed to where the wing can do the lift for you, they fold away, and then they're just the nacelle. So you'll see that in the Mach 3 configuration. The tip propeller.
This vehicle, you'll be flying this Block 1B. It's a little bit taller than the Block 1 that we'll be flying in 2020. First EM1, no crew, EM2 with crew. Four things we worry about from an aerodynamic standpoint.
Transports, features, airliners, the space launch system, as well as military airplanes.
You can watch this class. It just is like constant.
You can see the white splotches. So if we get a ding, it's very similar to repairing a piece of furniture at home. You sand it down smooth, put wood putty in there, wait for it to dry, and see if you take it back. So.
A capsule for that month. So some of the things that they are learning for the habitat for the surface, they can also apply for in space.
Coffin for 36 hours. So they have a little bit smaller shelter. It's more like a walk-in closet. You can sort of see it over here.
It's fine.
Practice for the astronauts. The that image over there is the original image of the Earth. They were
floating in space. It really tells you that we're fragile.
And so 90% of the science work that we do here at Langley is involved with Earth science.
So there's four key areas where we make those measurements. The upper
atmosphere. You see the pictures of the sun?
This is a situation where you have a pad abort and you don't make it back and you land, and there's 3,200 pounds of lead in there to move the center of gravity 8.5 inches forward. ILC Dover, we had maybe the world's largest sandbox. It was 4 foot by 30 by 80 foot long.
Inflatable air shells for entry. And our first tests are going to be here at Earth, really our long gate.
So you inflate this thing prior to getting to the atmosphere of wherever you're going. And then you re-enter, and it allows you to have much larger payloads.
So for this circle here is kind of the nominal size